If you're a fan of the channel, one thing you know is I don't stray away from jumping into subjects just because I don't know everything about them. Now, this thing is quirky, it's different, and it's cool. This is the new God Phoenix from a new channel sponsor, Model Rectifier Corporation. They import Italeri, Academy, Hobby Boss, and a bunch of other companies for model railroads, and they sent over this new God Phoenix kit. It's an all-new tool plastic kit of a cartoon that ran in the Japan and the United States towards the end of the 70s. They called it Gatchaman. They had different names for it over there. Over here, it was called Battle of the Planets. It was in the same animation style as like Voltron, Transformers. So it has these really bright colors. It looks really cool. Now, we're going to be building this jet that they use. And in that jet are numerous little vehicles with the people in there. They do include those as the models. We can do it as the flying jet on a stand. We can do it on landing gear. We can do it with these cool flame details. So let's rip open the box and see what's in it. We're going to show you some parts. Now, they say this kit does not require any painting, and I like the look at it. The plastic is bright, it's colorful, and it's molded in like a semi-gloss. Some is molded in almost a flat tone. It's really interesting. Check out this molding on this. It's beautiful for this off-white colored paint here, or the plastic. Reminds me of how Bandai molds things in such sharp colors and gets this intense level of detail on all the parts. Check out the turbines for the engine there. Now, a person could paint those or blackwash them, or build it as is. I'm gonna be doing this as a fan of the cartoon, if you are, and you just wanna build up a model. If you enjoy these, but you don't wanna spend all this time painting and detailing. We got nice panel lines on all the parts. This is really interesting. These parts should come off, of course, but that is such an interesting shape there that they decided to mold that in. Here we can see the landing gear bays. So you can see how big the plane's gonna be. It's not a little tiny thing. There's the intakes. You can actually see them right there in the picture. Molded open with the large grates on there. This looks like it's part of the head. You can see the eye molded in. You can see the inset, so we can add some red color in there. Red color plastic, so cool. So let's get out the rest of the white plastic, then we'll move on to the other colors. You can see parts of our wings. The trees are labeled with really clear letters. Excellent details. Now, this is not a press fit kit. They do recommend glue, and the manual will tell you what parts not to use glue on. Here are the figures and their little vehicles. They got little capes, faces on them. The faces are pretty blank on here. They're just like a smooth representation. Here we got the backs. We got like, it looks like capes are part of the vehicles, little flame effect. We got like a little mini tank here. Little rover here. This one reminds me of the vehicle that goes to the planet and Alien. We got rotors here. We got a little jet. Really cool little details. Little motorcycle here upside down. And those figures. I don't know if I'll be getting to paint those, but we're going to see them for scale. This tree here molded in a gray-black plastic. Battery holder. Base for the model. We got some landing gear here. You can add as much detail or as little as you want. Change it up. You can always go back and add detail later. Hand painting is a fun process. Battery cover. So you'll need three AA batteries. That's all that's not included in this kit. We got a nice blue color here. Electric blue. For all the blue accents on there. Nice molding. Giant trees. Check out the landing gear on that thing. Huge feet coming down. Posts for the wheels. Nice panel lines. We got this center compartment. Looks like it supports some of the tail structure as well. Put all these trees behind me. We got some loose wing parts. Looks like the wings can go up and down because we've got pivot joints there. We've got two of those parts. We've got another entire red tree. Here's those cheek feathers for the bird face that we saw in white. Those will just press into place. Stick with a little bit of glue. We got tail feathers, literally tail feathers, it looks like. We've got wing parts, red inserts. It's a very vibrant red color. Excellent detail, nice panel lines. I gotta go all the way to the other side of the desk. That's not all the stuff that's in the kit. Clear orange-red parts for the Phoenix effect. Ooh, we got a little yellow part hiding on there. Flame parts that will go over the wingtips and the nose for that Phoenix effect in the cartoon where it's like on fire, the rising of the Phoenix out of the fire. We got this little, it says warning. It's a little cover for the base on the hitch there. The little yellow piece there is for that nose. We've got what looks like a cover with some small panel lines on it. Impresses in the back for attachment. What else we got in here? We're going to grab some stuff. We're going to throw it on the table. We got a black, looks like the eyebrows of the nose piece for the bird. We got some polyvinyl caps, which are for the wheels. We've got some other things to hold like wings and attachments on the inside structure. This will have operated mechanisms via spring. We're going to look at those. This thing is so cool. We've got light reflective and light blocking tape included. You can see it's pre-cut. We've got some clear tape here for attaching LED wires inside. There are little strips on there. What else we got? We've got decals. We've got LED light kit. We got a set of stickers here. If you just want to put the eyes on, some of the black striping, you can see it there. Go very quick build on that if you want to use water slides. Beautiful decal sheet printed by Cartograph, so you know they're going to be high quality. Same stripes we saw, same colorations and all that, but just a much more detailed sheet with more callouts and emblems and logos also for the little figures and the little vehicles that we saw. We're still not done. This kit, it includes an entire light kit, momentary switch, colored LED lights, all the attachment points. You get to build a little battery box. This will be fun for us. And then finally, a set of springs for all the different things that can be attached, little hatches, little doors. We got a set of springs in a plastic bag. The manual even looks cool. They rarely show manuals, but when they look this awesome, looks as simple as Lego the way they've laid it out. Coloring, adding it on to pre-assembled parts, sub-assemblies so you know where you were and what you're working on. Very nicely done. So we welcome Model Rectifier Corporation on with this kit. I'm going to get to building it. There is no real painting section, so I'm going to try to jump in and out of the build process as we go, and I'll see you soon. At this point in the build, everything has been going together super smooth. The fit on this is immaculate. You can see the join in there. These are actually numerous pieces that all come apart in some sort of reveal later. Look at the fit. I pull that up with the spring motion. Look at that fit all the way around the nose. These cheek pieces, the eyebrows, the crest, the nose piece are all just pushed into place and a tiny drop of glue is applied. I've been using Tamiya glue. Normally I like bonding. On this one I've been using my Tamiya glue, and the only reason I switched was because of the super tiny applicator that comes with Tamiya glue. Places like Model Roundup carry that as well. So we've got the bottom where the landing gear is, we've got that assembled, we've got the engines assembled inside there. We've got what looks like it's going to be some sort of cargo bay on either side. We've got that all pressed together and just lightly, light taps of glue. Now the manual gets me all the way to that point, and it says if you don't have the LED light kit, because Model Rectifier Corporation, when you order your new God Phoenix, it's going to be in there automatically, the light kit, so you don't have to worry about that, buying it separately. They're going to include it for the US releases. For assembling without LED, we would jump to step 6, but we're going to get all the LED stuff out, and look how clear they make it. They tell you exactly to bring it down to the terminals and wrap the wire around. They show you what all the terminals look like that they're going to be talking about, and we're going to go ahead, and then the next couple of steps, we're going to get all those lights in. Or most of them. We're going to get them into the engines and the light bay. They even show you where to apply some of the light blocking tape so it doesn't shine through the model. We don't have to paint the interior. We don't have to hide the lighting or anything. We just have to put it in as they suspect. So I'm going to work on getting those lights in. We got that cool bird face. Love that thing. And the assembly's been going so nicely. You can see it's got springs in it. Obviously, we're not going to be displaying it completely upside down, but in these little parts here, these little joins are where the springs are hidden. We can see the size of the springs that they're having you use. These little guys, this is a magnetic welding tray, a parts tray. These are awesome to have for modeling. We got the larger springs coming up. These little springs go together. They push onto their actuators really tight so they don't go ping across the room. And that is looking spectacular. So I'm going to keep putzing on that. When we get some of those LEDs in, I'll be right back. With the LED lights and the movable wings assembled, lightly glued together with that nice Tamiya glue, I got some clamps on the back end because the tail fin here was a little warped up. So I just held it in place while the glue dries and it'll be absolutely fine. In fact, yep, they've been holding for about 2 minutes. They're fine as they are. So we've got the LED light kit installed. You can see the light blocking tape is installed in the front. Underneath the light and above the light, that is our will be the light that's probably underneath the nose here. When you open up that access panel where we showed how the head moves up, we've got our two lights running into our engines back there and back there. Those are those clear red parts on the flame part tree. And then we've got our cargo bays with the lights routed out. You can look inside, see all those lights are routed to those connection terminals down there. We took some pictures of them as well, so hopefully I'll remember to put them in the video, but those are right there. Those little teeny tiny wire connections. We're not running a lot of amperage through this. We're just running 3 volts, or 4.5 volts actually, and at very low amps. So you can see those little connections. This will be touching the stand, so you can put it on the stand and remove it. You don't have to leave it on the stand permanently to make it work. So that's how that's going to look once that's all routed up. It's a simple light kit. It's got 5 lights on it. Nothing super duper fancy. We've got the upper part of the body here with the wings. Now the wings will come off. You can see the wings will actually click into place. It's got kind of a cool sound. That's what they'll look like. They've got the different colored ailerons in them and everything. That slips in to the upper part of the body. We've got that cool looking tail fin, which is colored plastic sandwiched in between the parts. I ran a little bit of glue here, and I ran glue at the very tips to get it to hold together tightly. The kit does need glue, they say that right away, all these little holes and stuff. It's not a press fit kit, but everything fits so finely that you just need a very, very, very small bits of glue on here. We don't need to drown it or anything. We wouldn't want to, because otherwise we'd have to paint it to cover that up. So everything is going together super easy. After this, you see me, they having the two body parts are put together to sandwich those wings. We'll glue them together. After that, we're going to start putting some motion parts with the larger springs in the nose of the fuselage and working those through different colored plates. You can see how they tell you to assemble it, where they mark for no cement and put cement on. So it's all going real smooth. Then we'll move on to the landing gear. When we get onto that kind of stuff, before I get to assembling the base, we'll come back again. I've got the fuselage halves together, the upper and lower half, and I've got the nose on, the Phoenix's face and head, so it does look pretty awesome, and it's a very nice size at this point. You can see we've still got to do the hangar bay LEDs. They say that you can just press the LEDs in. My recommendation, a little bit of super glue. Put a little super glue right on the actual LED bulb itself. Press it into the fitting and use a little activator to make sure it holds. You don't want to get stuff all together and have a bulb fall out. So we're going to have bulbs in the engines and in the hangers and up in the landing pad on the nose here. So this looks really cool. We can see how this operates now. The nose will lift and that will sit like so. And the fit is, I mean, look at that. That's a separate piece. This is a separate piece. The fit on that is exquisite. Where I didn't have a great fit was getting the fuselage together in the back here. You can see that's still kind of open there. I've got to clamp it a little while longer and apply some more glue. That, no matter what I did, no matter how I tried to route the wires, it was a real difficult fit in the back. So when we get off camera, while I'm working on other parts, they're going to have me working on the rear stabilizer and everything, the vertical stabilizer. I'm going to clamp that and apply some more model glue and hold that together. But the front fit fine, the nose fits fine, the fuselage and all, it looks awesome. The things operate as they should. The wings go up, the wings go down. Those large clicks are from the spring-activated little switches. We got everything going the way it should. So that's working. We've even got this little hatch here where there'll be a vehicle that we'll place on the spring here. And that locks into place. So you got all kinds of cartoon ability with it. That'll be all lit up. Those arrows will be lit up underneath there. So that's pretty cool. That all goes together like so. And we can see underneath where we're going to be connecting this to the base with the little wire connectors and doing our landing gear, which are removable. And you can put them back on. I'm going to put them on because it all can fit when it's on the stand. And I want to display it all as once. I don't want to lose any parts. They're going to have me, when we come back, I'm going to do the vertical stab I'm going to do the landing gear. I'm going to do the instead of the dress plates underneath, which is where the landing gear would be, those will be down. I've got to put the last red pieces inside. The hangers, push those in. They show you where to block it off when you want to block it off with little doors, all that kind of stuff. And then we're going to build the base. So when I get done with the base, we'll come back, take a look, see if the LEDs work. To get the model to this point where it's all set up and ready to go is pretty simple. Now, when I did the wiring for the LEDs, the manual makes it so super clear, shows you exactly where to put the little battery holders in the battery box, shows you where to put the switch. You don't need to solder anything. You just need to twist wires through terminal connectors and then just give them a quick twist with your fingers. Now, I went ahead, since I have all the soldering equipment, and I soldered everything together so it never comes loose, but it really goes together super easy. Everything is color-coded with the wires. They show you how to do it. They make it easy on you. They don't fight you at all. They even show you how to use that last big spring for the push button and how to push the base together. Now, the base here and the aircraft and the none of that is glued together. That's all just press fit together for me. It all fit lovely. I went and glued all the little vehicles together so you can see how they are. I'll have closer pictures later. I'm not going to go ahead and paint the figures or the vehicles, but they do look really awesome. You can see the fine detail on those things. They're just exquisite little models. Teeny tiny. What I wanted to do is just do a quick review on this so you folks can see what's in it. I know it's not a massively popular subject, but it is cool and it is fun. And you can see all the detail on it. Now, if you don't want to display it with the landing gear, just save your doors from your two sheets there. You've got the white in the front and the blue in the rear. Those will be landing gear doors. We've got the awesome figures up close. We got five figures from the show. Three of which have capes that attach separately, two of which have their capes already on, all that kind of stuff. Those are beautiful. Now, what I'll be doing is I'll be finishing up the model by putting on these nice cartograph decals. We've got logos for the tail, we got eyes, we've got the cheeks, we've got some vents for these little wing things here. We've got a big red stripe for the top of the fuselage there. We've got some other call-outs, and then we've also got really small badging for the figures as well on there. You can decorate those. So I'm going to get ahead, work on that. You could also use the stickers if you want, depending on where you're going to be placing things. Sometimes the stickers are quicker and easier. We'll look at all the features of the model. Now, the LED lights work perfectly. We'll lift it up. Press our switch there, and you can see the ones in the engine, the ones in the cargo bays, and the ones for the landing strip in the nose of the aircraft. They're all there. We've got these cool optional missiles installed. Those you can pull off, and you can insert on the white tree here. There are blank out panel cover panels to put over that, but when I get mine all done, I want to put it all together. I'm going to show you how it displays in like full attack launch mode. We've got the flames all glued together. They're clear parts. I use that Tamiya model glue on them. We don't see any fogging, any bad design on any of those. These go on the wingtips. None of that on there. It all looks pretty awesome. We've got firing missiles. You can see all the missiles. These are all press fit as well. You can see all the missiles are coming out with their little anime flame behind them. They're on each side like that. You can take the landing gear on and off, switch them in and out. These are little launching arms that come out of the cargo bay and hold on to each vehicle. We've got vehicles that'll press into the hatches in here. I'll be installing all the vehicles inside there so we always have them with us. And then eventually down the road, I'm going to save all those figures. I'll be painting them up and putting them. I'll probably super glue them to the base just so it's all one big unit together. So I'm going to put the decals on. We will come back for that final. The new God Phoenix is all done. I wanted to do this as a really simple build where I didn't have to put paint on everything, and that's exactly what I got. Now, there is a little bit of wash done to get the panel lines to stand out. You can see the white and the red and the tail feathers and all the panel lines that are engraved in there. I wanted them to stand out a little bit, so I did use panel line accent color. That's not really painting, that's just dabbing it into the panel lines and wiping off excess. The rest is the beautiful cartograph decals that lay down perfectly. And the colored plastic as it is, I did not spray paint anything. We didn't do any detail painting sections. We didn't get any groovy music on this one because I didn't do any paint work and extra detailing. I wanted to see how easy this would be if you picked this up for the kiddos, gave it to them for the weekend, and see what they could do with it. And without one big drop of paint, they come out with a really, really nice model. Now we got those cartograph water slide decals. If you don't trust them with water slides, they've got the stickers that they can put on and will accent the model. You could also use like a Gundam pencil to go in and draw those panel lines. You could do it any way you want. Of course, the Model Rectifier Corporation release has the LED light kit in it. So you're gonna get the light up engines, the light up cargo bay, and the light up launch pad in the front of the fuselage. And it has all these cool action and maneuvers. It's got the five vehicles at the base going around in white. It's got the five figures, which are of course larger sizes, so you can actually see them. You can make a little base. It's got covers for the side missiles. I'm gonna be putting the missiles on. You can do it with the landing gear up. They give you all the panels necessary to do it with the landing gear up. You can build it when it's launching all the vehicles with the cargo bay doors open. They give you these nice arms to drop the vehicles out that are going to go underneath there. The manual tells you which ones. We're going to have the Phoenix flames on the nose and on the wings. We got the missile shooting. There's going to be pictures at the end with all this stuff going on in the photo area, but I wanted to assemble it right now. You can see the lights. Converting it is super easy. We just grab the nose, we go down seamlessly, we just put those wings down, and yeah, everything holds together nicely. You can hear those clicking with those springs and everything in there. You can turn the lights on, turn them off, runs on three AA batteries. Very easy to do. We'll get the box out of the way because the nose extends that a little bit. Once we have it down, this is the position I think it looks the coolest in, with its gigantic, you know, 12-wheel landing gear coming down and the four in the front. It looks really awesome, and those panel line accents really enhance the model along with the color decals. Get the eyes in there and everything. You can see that it's a seamless assembly. Had a little bit of an issue with the back seam. I probably got a wire in the way or something, but otherwise it looks awesome. And of course we've got like the back door opens up to launch a vehicle. We've got this pad on the top. We can slide it so that that will launch a vehicle. You can see this little spring pad coming up. It's hard to do with one hand free for the camera. It's got this little spring-actuated launching pad for one of the vehicles to come flying out of the top, and that just pushes back down. It all looks really cool, and all those little tiny no-step, no-push, automatic hinge, all these other kind of emblems, you know, you want to put those on there because it adds more detail to the kit. So, a lot of fun to build. In fact, just assembly, not the panel lines, nothing. Assembly with the light kit and all that, I got done all in the first day. Took about 4.5 hours to glue and press everything together. That is absolutely outstanding build quality. The longest thing was waiting for the glue where I didn't get the seams that close in the back, but now that they're glued together, they look great. I'm gonna get this over to the photo booth. Once again, we welcome Model Rectifier Corporation. We're gonna be getting some cool stuff from them. We're gonna be doing an unboxing of that F-104 Starfighter. We're gonna be building some Hobby Boss tanks, some Italeri models. We're gonna be getting all kinds of stuff from them that I can't get from like Model Roundup and Round 2. They're gonna be sending me some goofy stuff like this that I just think is so different and so cool that I wanna get it built up, and some more military kits and all that that they will be distributing in the United States. So thanks for watching the workshop. Nice quick build review. No paint needed. Go out. I will put a link down to their website for the new God Phoenix. Otherwise, just Google it and find it at your local hobby store. Thanks for watching the workshop. We'll see all of you at the next review.